last night I came upstairs to do a beat, and this is what I came up with. I used the A major and a G major chord. Show you how I put the beat together. I MIDI'd up the Privia to the computer, and here's the chords. Piece it together. And of course, you know, I quantized it, so here we go. Piece by piece. Then I added this extra. That in there. Remember, everything, I'm just piecing everything together, showing y'all the process. So then here it is right here, the little extra part added in there. Show you what I did with these chords. I did not actually use I didn't use it that way. I put it in my push too, and I chopped. Let me show you what I did. I put the drums to it. About push two, it's incredible. That was cool, but I found that I wanted to chop, so I took that same melody that I played and I chopped it up into the push two. Let me show you what I did. So I got the melody into the Push 2. I got it in classic mode. I fixed the start and the end point. And I basically, I just started freaking it in classic mode. So I was like, it's endless. Like, you could do whatever you feel, and that's what I did. You can be like, and basically, this is what I came up with. I was playing that, right? I was like, okay, that's kind of hot, right? Then I brought the drums back. Let me see what it sound like. My bad, y'all. So you see where I'm going with it? And after I did that, I was like, okay, I like that. Let me mess around with a little bit more. Let me show you what I did. So I had made another sequence, and basically I just kind of used the melody that I played and just held the key down. This is what I came up with. Sequence right here. So I was like, okay, cool. I like that. But I took it a step further. Let me show you what I did. So what I did after that was I duplicated this track here. I duplicated this track and created chops and put it in the slicer mode, and I chopped them up, and these are what I came up with. And then you just freak it. And that's what I did. So this is when I started getting creative. I was like, okay, all right, let me go ahead. I got my chops in here. I like that. I like to be able to feel the chop. Remember, I played the melody out, and I just like something about the pad feeling how I move that allows me to be more creative. So that's what I did. And here it is. And that's just one sequence. Remember, it's endless. What you feel. And here it is with the drums. I mean, it's endless. So, you know, you do what you gotta do. And that's basically it. I did add some other elements in there, but I gotta clean them up. But that's basically really done, you know. I'll put a bass line to it and keep it moving. Basically, I started messing around with the delay time and the feedback, and I did some automation on it, and I came up with this. See how it's moving? The automation right there. And to enhance it, I put an effects on there. Tweaking, messing around, that's what you get, you know? Bring the drums back in. I kind of wanted to be a little off, so that's how I wanted to play, because I'm going to do some fill-ins with it, the bass line. Y'all watching. I'm gonna go ahead and mix it down and then chop this video up and get it popping. Thanks for watching. My name is Granddaddy Frost. Peace.